गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज आवर चैप्टर द एड्रेस बाय मार्गा मिंको. लेट अस कम टू नो अबाउट द राइटर ऑफ द चैप्टर. द चैप्टर इज रिटन बाय मार्गा मिंको हु वॉज बॉर्न इन 1920 इन नीदरलैंड. हर पैन नेम इज मार्गा मिंको एंड शी हैज वर्कड एज अ जर्नलिस्ट एंड राइटर. द लैंग्वेज विच शी हैज यूज्ड इज डच लैंग्वेज. स्टूडेंट्स लेट्स कम टू द थीम ऑफ द चैप्टर. द थीम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज related to war. War is a phenomena that is followed by many chaos. People have to go through many physical as well as mental sufferings. It makes the people greedy. It changes their behavior. Students, this story is a touching story of a girl who has lost her mother in the war. She wanted to see the things of her mother which were kept at Mrs. Dorling's house. But when she goes there, Mrs. Dorling refuses to recognize her. Later on, when she came in the contact of all these things, the things lost their value because they were kept in their strange atmosphere. Now she realized that materialistic things cannot give happiness to anyone. So she decided to forget the address and move on. Now let us discuss about the characters. There are three main characters. One is the narrator. She is the daughter of Mrs. S. Second one is Mrs. S. She is the mother of narrator who died in the war and who had kept all her precious belongings with Mrs. Dorling. The third character is Mrs. Dorling, who is described as an old acquaintance of Mrs. S. The story is divided into pre-war and post-war times. In pre-war times, Mrs. S. came into the contact of Mrs. Dorling, who suddenly renewed their connection and offered Mrs. S. to keep all her belongings with her in order to save at the time of war. She offered her that she will keep all the things with her when they will leave that place because of the war. Mrs. S. was so simpleton, she came into the manipulation of Dorling and gave her all expensive and precious things. But during the war, Mrs. S. had lost her life. The cruel clutches of war has taken her life, but the narrator, the daughter of Mrs. S., survived. In the post-war time, Mrs. S.'s daughter, means the narrator, decided to go to Mrs. Dorling's house as she wanted to take the belongings of her mother back. In the beginning of the story, we see that narrator goes to Mrs. Dorling's house. She rings the bell of her house. Mrs. Dorling opens the gate, but she does not show any sign of recognition. She refuses to recognize her. Even for a few seconds, narrator also thought that she might have come at the wrong place. But when she saw that Mrs. Dorling was wearing the green knitted cardigan of her mother, then she got sure that she was at the right place. But she was very sorry to see the changed behavior of Mrs. Dorling. Narrator wanted to talk to her, but that lady cautiously closed the door and did not allow her to come in. So after some time, the narrator left the place. When she was going back, she remembered about the bygone days. She remembered how her mother had told her about Mrs. Dorling, how she gave her the address number 46 Marconi Street. She told that Mrs. Dorling used to come to their house on regular basis. Every time she left their house, she took something with her. She told that she wanted to save all their nice possessions. The next day, the narrator saw Mrs. Dorling going out of their house with a heavy suitcase. She also had a dim recognition of Mrs. Dorling's face. With the intention of looking at the things of her mother, touching them, feeling them and getting them back, she went to Mrs. Dorling's house. But Mrs. Dorling did not allow her to come in. After a few days, she again decided to go to that place. On her second visit, she was welcomed by the daughter of Mrs. Dorling. She was a 15 years old girl. She opened the gate. Mrs. Dorling was not at home. So narrator decided to wait for the mother. The girl accompanied her to the passage. The narrator went inside the house
The narrator saw an old-fashioned iron candle holder. The girl made her sit in the living room. The narrator was horrified to find herself in a room she knew and she didn't know. She found herself amidst the familiar thing which she longed to see again. But now she was troubled to see them in strange atmosphere. She had no courage to look around, so she decided to get up and go outside without taking those things. She resolved to forget the address and moved on. So students, this was the summary of the chapter, The Address. I hope everybody must have understood. Thank you.